Our last phase is the end of the Cold War. During the period of 1979 up to 1987, this bitterness did not last for a long time period, because in 1985, Mikhail Gorbachev became the president of the Soviet Union, and he has presented a new political thinking in front of the people of the Soviet Union. He gave a good ideas of improving the relationship with the Western countries. So in July 1991, a strategic arm reduction treaty has been signed between the Soviet Union and the USA. In USA that time, George Bush was the president. So they have signed this treaty to reduce the nuclear weapons. Okay, so in December 1991, the Soviet Union was dissolved. Okay, in the 1991, Soviet Union was disintegrated. So in February 1992, President Bush and the Russian President Boris Yeltsin have made a formal declaration regarding the end of the Cold War. So due to the Mikhail Gorbachev beta, the Cold War has became up to the end. After the end of the Cold War, Russia is participating in the NATO. Okay, it is the member of the NATO, and many countries became the republic which were the part of the Soviet Union. After the disintegration, now there was no any fight between these two countries. Now next was the one, now they were facing the new challenges. Okay, new challenges regarding the development were there in front of both the independent countries. Okay, America was already independent, but the countries which get separated from the Soviet Union after the disintegration of the Soviet Union, so there were a lot of challenges in front of them. So our next topic is challenge to the bipolarity. It is a system under which both the parties are having the equal capabilities. Okay, so the decision of newly independent countries was to remain non-aligned and not to join any of the power bloc. During this period, beta, we have read about some countries were there which haven't joined the Soviet Union or which haven't even joined the America. So what they remain the non-aligned. They remain separate from both the countries. The countries of the South Asia, Africa, and these were the non-aligned countries, and they have called the conference in 1995 in the Badang. Okay, in the Badang, it is in Indonesia. In Indonesia, India was also included in this conference. India has also joined this conference. Total 29 countries were the members of this meeting. Countries were from the Asia and the Africa, and they have founded the non-aligned movement. They founded a NAM in this conference. Okay, in this Budang conference, they founded a NAM. This means non-aligned movement. Under non-aligned movement, that we are not aligned with the Soviet and we are not aligned with the US. We are separate. We are the third world. Okay, this US and Soviet, these both were the two worlds. Okay, and the non-aligned countries. Okay, non-aligned countries were the member of a third world. Okay, these were the almost underdeveloped or the developing countries. So, let us back. Foundation, in the foundation of this movement, India was involved. From India, PM Nehru was the member. Yugoslavia was involved. Marshal Tito was the president. Egypt, Mr. Nasir was the president. And Ghana, Nkrumah. Okay, Nkrumah was the president of Ghana, and the Sukarno was the president of Indonesia. These were the five presidents of the, these were the five members who have founded this non-aligned movement to remain neutral during the Cold War and to play an independent role in the international politics. In this way, beta, almost half of the world have rejected the polar system and they had paved a way to multipolarity. They have made their own comment.